Konnichiwa, Satoko desu. Welcome back to my Easy Japanese lesson. On our last lesson, we learned onegai. That means please when you are asking for something in a casual way. In a formal way, onegai shimasu. And today, we're going to learn one of the most important words for us Japanese. Because we love food. So that word is itadakimasu. It literally means I'm receiving or I'm having. And you might say, what's got to do with food? Because itadakimasu is a word said before eating to show the appreciation for the food. So it's kind of like a quick prayer. You know, at some household, they hold hands and then they say a prayer before eating, right? It's kind of like that, but very quick version of it. And we are not exactly religious in Japan, but I would say we're conveniently religious. What I mean by that is on a Christmas day, we go to church and pray. And a week later on a New Year's day, we go to temple or shrine to pray. So we are flexible when it comes to religion. So let's take a look at the pronunciation first. Itadakimasu. There are six sounds, six Japanese characters. It sounds long, but it's actually easy to memorize. So let's break it down. Ita. It is like a country, Italy's Ita. And daki. Have you seen those yellow duck toy, like squishy one? Look like this. I hope you like my drawing. It's called daki. So ita daki. Mas. We already know this from gozaimasu, the same mas. It sounds like mask, but without K. Itadakimasu. And I want to introduce you to how we actually use this itadakimasu in a sentence. Something o itadakimasu. So that means I'm receiving or having something. So this is a polite way of saying it. So if you want to say, I'm having sushi. O sushi o itadakimasu. Osushi. Do you remember from our last lesson? If you add o in front of a noun or an item, it becomes politer, right? Osushi is sushi. O itadakimasu. Receiving, having. And so this o is a particle. So how do you know when to use o? So you can ask this question. What am I itadakimasu? What am I having? And if the answer can go in front of o, and that's when you can use o. Something o itadakimasu. And there is a past tense to this itadakimasu. That is itadakimashita. Do you remember? Mas becomes mashita in the past tense, right? Arigatou gozaimasu. That was thank you very much in a past tense. Arigatou gozaimashita, right? So if you want to say, I had sushi, that's osushi o itadakimashita. So that's the past tense, all right? So let's go back to our food situation here. So here's a conversation. A server or the person who cooked the meal for you is serving you a meal by saying, dozo means go ahead. And you, eater, would say, itadakimasu. It's a quick prayer before eating. And so most of the cases, by just saying dozo, that's good enough. But if you want to say, enjoy your meal more officially, you can say those words. And I'm going to quickly introduce you to this. And the first one is meshiagare. This is actually an order form of meshiagaru, which means eat in a politer version of it. So since it is an older form, I wouldn't use meshiagare to somebody older than me. Actually, my grandma used this meshiagare very often to me. So you can just say meshiagare, or you can add dozo and then meshiagare. Okay? And then second way is meshiagatte. It's polite, but still casual. And so I would use this to acquaintances or your friends. And you can also add dozo and dozo meshiagatte. And the politest way is you just gonna add kudasai, means please. So meshiagatte kudasai. Or you can add dozo meshiagatte kudasai. That means go ahead, please eat, equals enjoy your meal. And today's lesson was itadakimasu. I hope you get to use this itadakimasu in Japan before eating the meal. And hope you enjoy this lesson too. And domo arigatou gozaimashita. And if you still haven't, please subscribe. And I'll see you guys on our next lesson. Ja ne! Bye bye!